fastest growing sport in the world. It's taken over NBA, NFL. It's huge. It's a mainstream sport. Japan, there was an event in Japan called Pride Fight Championships. They used to get 70 to 90,000 people watching an event, and that was massive. I'm Sol the Hulk, and I'm coming to a city near you. Watching the first couple of UFCs that first ever came out with the Gracies and stuff like that, and that got me hooked. This is the best shape, by far the best shape I've ever been in. I'm stronger, I'm fitter, I'm smashing, I'm just smashing everything that I do, and everything I dedicate, everything I do is just dedicate to my training, I wake up feeling good, I wake up feeling sharp, I'm positive. Before I used to wake up and I used to think, okay, geez, it was just like a routine. I had to go to training and just train and see what happens. But now I just want to get in there and I just want to like train and train and train and be the best. So this is the best I've ever felt, the best I've ever looked. So you'll be seeing more of me like in the next couple of years.
If he believes he can do it, he can do it. And I think that's good. Like for an MMA athlete, confidence is a skill.
I do the MMA strength and conditioning, which involves like a lot of the movements that Sol does in the ring, whether it's pushing someone off, rolling, jumping, sidestepping, using the core. We do all that as well. We want to maintain that strength, maintain the power, and try and get him to move like a little man. So he trains with the best. So I think that he's world class. Yeah, he's trained with the best. So I think he can go far. So
I've been doing it for the last 16 years. I started off with boxing as a kid, then went from boxing into Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and I went from that doing Greco and freestyle wrestling. Competed with both disciplines, with Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu and Greco and freestyle wrestling, for the Australia, represented Australia in Brazil for Abu Dhabi. See, I think I went to the UFC back then at Premature. I had some problems leading up to that fight. 3 weeks before I was supposed to fight, I had to fly back to Australia for some emergency stuff. Then went back and fought in UFC, and it was a bad kind of time in my life. But you know what? You live and learn from that, and you come back bigger and stronger. I think now it's like you just got to believe in yourself, and which I have. I haven't stopped. And I compete against myself every day, so being the best, and I believe in myself. So every day is like we train three times a day. It's hard, but it's I enjoy it. I prefer that than waking up at 5 o'clock in the morning, going to a job where you've got a bricklay. Nothing against the bricklayers, but and then it's pouring rain and you're wet, and then you got to get the bricks, you got to get the cement. You know what? Like, I can't do that. And I kind of drew him and just waited, and then I threw a left hook and dropped him. But I was thinking, if he threw a kick, I'll capitalize straight away so he doesn't throw another kick. So as soon as he throws a kick, bang, come in straight away. But he didn't throw anything, and I threw a left hook. He went down, he went to shoot, and then I finished it off then. So I guess when you see something, you go for it quick. And then when it ended up in 28 seconds, it was good. You can't really dictate how a fight's going to go, but I'm happy it went, the way it went. But just believing in myself, that's the best thing, believing in myself. There's nothing better than that, because before it used to be a struggle, but now I'm good, so.
A lot of fighting's mental, so I think, when everything comes together, then then he'll be unstoppable, really. So.